Hey everybody, welcome back to Record-ology. Hope you're having a great weekend so far. Today we're going to take a look at a failed format and a very interesting piece of history. This is a paper record. What could go wrong with that? It's actually quite old, older than you might guess. Now, when I received this, I didn't really know the history of these. And if I had to, you know, pick a date in my mind, I would have guessed, maybe the early 50s without looking at the title. I mean, just by the, you know, the nature of what it is, I would say early 50s. It's actually much earlier than that. It's between 1930 and 1932, because this is an example of the very short-lived record label Hit of the Week. And it was a weekly release of Ultra Treat cheap records. And I'm talking 15 cents to 20 cents, which even at that time was considered bargain basement. So how do you recover your costs when you're producing records that cheap? Well, you make them out of paper. And that's just what this is. This is somewhere between cardboard and paper, you know, card stock is, I guess, what I would really call this. But it's essentially a piece of paper. And on this side, you have a durium coat, which durium is sort of a vintage and synthetic resin. And, you know, it hardens the surface and allows for, you know, a record to be placed sort of, you know, like a laminate on the paper. There's a lot of issues, you know, from a physical standpoint. They're famous for curling like this. You can see that, you know, it's curling. The durium is probably shrinking on this side and pulling the other side back. Almost all of these Hit of the Week records were one-sided. They didn't do the two-sided thing. And actually, the whole weird flexi throwaway, you know, cheapo disc format kind of started in Europe. There was a lot of different materials during the very early 30s that they tried producing records out of. And in the US, the attempt was made to do it on paper. And this represents the United States attempt at this kind of subset program off, program? No, okay, let's use your words. Subset format off of the main, you know, 78 record format. So yeah, this is a, you know, fairly good condition. Obviously the running groove, I wouldn't put a needle in there, but at the same time, we're gonna try and play it. I'll show you a trick on how to do that. But yeah, they're making 500,000 of these a week. And some big name artists recorded on this format, including, or on this label, including Duke Ellington, among others. This one is, I don't know why my focus is giving me grief today. This is the I'll Be Blue Just Thinking of You, Hit of the Week Orchestra, Bert Hirsch, director. That was sort of an in-house musician, I think. There was a lot of, he was one of the regulars. And if you look, there's like this texture here, which at first I thought that was like, am I looking through the disc? But no, it's actually, it's gotta be the paper behind there, the cardstock. Foxtrot, this is interesting. Look how it says, Whirring Wending. I have no idea what that means, why that is, etc., etc. Now, what doesn't make sense to me is this, and perhaps you can fill me in. I'm sure you can. So Hit of the Week is a record label. And although, you know, some famous artists would, you know, make recordings on here, their whole thing was to present the hit song of the week. So were they cover versions? Were they, you know, did they license their original recordings? That's what I'm not 100% sure of. But anyway, there you go. The Great Depression killed this company off. They changed hands a couple of times and then, you know, they were gone. If you want to learn more, check out Wikipedia. And that's all there is to say about this. It is, you know, in pretty rough condition. We're going to listen to it anyway. For that, I'm going to use the Collegiate. I'm just going to stick it right on there. 78 RPM. I do not know what's up with the autofocus today. Because of the curling and having mercy on my tone arm, we're going to put a bowl over the top of this to flatten it out a little bit. My understanding is that the sound quality on these durium records isn't going to be super high quality. The fidelity really wasn't great. But if you're interested in owning one of these for historical purposes, like I have this one, you know, they can be obtained on eBay. Oh, that's cool. They're not that expensive. You know, 10, 20 bucks, you can get one, no problem. All right, let's go ahead and give it a listen. Thank you. sound's actually not that bad. It's, you know, on par to a 78 from what I can hear. I'm just listening on this player. And yes, we're using a microgroove stylus, so, you know, we're not getting the full benefit of that wide groove. But considering this is like a great value record on paper, I think we'll be fine.
I thought we'd play a while, forget and say goodbye. But the memory of your smile just makes me want to cry. I'll be blue just thinking of you and loving you too from now on.
That's awesome. That's cool. I mean, it, you know, it sounds pretty dang good, actually. That's a recording from 1930 to 33. I could have looked up the exact, gone on Discogs and looked it up, but suffice to say, that's old. Let's just say it's old. We can all agree on that. Also interesting, Durium Products Corporation of New York. Now, after, please don't tell me I'm touching the grooves. I mean, come on, guys. Come on. But anyway, after this was gone, in terms of this format and this, you know, product, there were similarly designed, and by that I mean paper-backed, you know, Durium records, much smaller though, that were sold at newsstands. And I think these were actually sold at newsstands as well. So something interesting and something different. Let's take a close-up look here. I wonder if I have my autofocus turned off. I don't know why it's acting like that. But if you look at the groove modulation, that looks just like a regular record. You know, it's got sort of a polished look to it. I don't know if that's the Durium or whatnot. Obviously, it is chipping off the edge. I see some examples online where it's real bad, but this one's pretty much playable start to finish. It's an interesting concept, sort of a very early flexi disc, if you will, but something interesting to have. I love interesting, unique records. I also like it when the camera works. But yeah, anyway, that's what I'm up to today, guys. Tell me down in the comments what you're working on this weekend, what kind of fun things you're having. You know, as things kind of tighten up here in line with what we talked about yesterday, you know, it's good to kind of dig through the archives, see what you have, see what you've, you know, maybe not listened to or looked into. If you're like me, you've got records that you haven't even listened to. So dig those out, give them a listen, see what you find. If you find anything interesting, always let me know down in the comments below. Love to hear from you guys. But anyway, working on a really cool show for you tomorrow. But most importantly, guys, stay safe out there. Stay safe out there. God bless. Happy record hunting. Happy record listening. I think we should go back to that. Happy record listening. Maybe hold off on the hunting for a while. Maybe online hunting. Or be very careful. But anyway, we'll see you tomorrow, guys. Take care.